My Big Dumb Invisible Dragon, written by Angie Lucas, illustrated by Birgitta Sif. Have you ever seen an invisible dragon? Neither had I. But one day, last May, a giant one swooped in and landed on my head, right on top of my head. It was the day Ollie's mom came to get us from Turtle Hill Park, instead of my mom. She had a funny look on her face. She opened her mouth 3 times before any words came out. I don't know if the dragon rode to the park with Ollie's mom or if he was already there hiding in the trees. All I know is I didn't see him coming, and once he was there, he would not go away. Dad and I had to get used to making dinner without Mom there. We had to get used to how quiet it was in the car without her singing along to the radio. We had to get used to movie night without her famous peanut brittle popcorn, but that big dumb dragon didn't even notice. He moved right in and made himself at home. He curled up on my chest every night when I was going to sleep. I swear, he must have weighed a ton. He made it super hard to get out of bed in the morning. At school, he cast a ginormous shadow that followed me everywhere. And if you think it was easy to stand up straight with a dragon on my head, let me tell you, it wasn't. I think he's the reason some kids didn't talk to me as much anymore. Some days I ignored him. I pretend he wasn't there at all. I played hard and laughed like crazy, even louder and crazier than before, but that didn't make him leave. Other days I got angry. You can't believe how mad I got. I yelled and shouted at him, at everyone. What did that dragon do? He put on his headphones and tuned me out. There were also days when I'd reach up and pull his big heavy wings around me. I would curl up like a caterpillar and hide away for hours. It wasn't always so bad to have him around. Still, almost every day, I tried to make a deal with him. If you'll just get lost, I'll never say a bad word ever again, I told him. I thought maybe if he left, things could go back to the way they were. But he didn't seem to care what I wanted, not a bit. Then one day, when the sky was filled with cotton candy clouds, Ollie invited me back to the park. I made myself roll and cartwheel and race down Turtle Hill just like before. I ran so blazing fast that my hair stood straight up, like uncooked spaghetti, which made Ollie giggle. Then something happened that I wasn't expecting at all. For the first time in months, I forgot all about my dragon. When we ran out of breath, we flopped down on the grass and took turns spotting shapes on the clouds. I see a giant octopus, I said. Does that look like a chicken to you? Ollie asked. There's a pig, or is that a bear? I asked. That one kind of looks like a dinosaur, Ollie said. Actually, I'm pretty sure it's a dragon. I don't know what that dragon saw up there in the clouds, but after that day, he started soaring even higher and staying away longer. He often disappeared during gym and recess. Sometimes he missed a whole soccer game. Once he was gone for an entire weekend, but he came back just in time for my birthday party. I tried all my tricks to make him go away. Skedaddle, vamoose. But what do you think he did? He put on a rainbow-striped cone hat and stayed for the party. I finally just gave him a piece of my birthday cake. That night, as I waited for sleep, which can take a while when there's a big dumb dragon in your bed, I realized something. My dragon didn't feel as heavy as he did back when I was 6. I guess my birthday wish came a little bit true. Hey, remember when I asked if you ever seen an invisible dragon? That was a silly question. You can never see one by looking straight at it. You have to look at the person underneath.